Okay, first and probably the most important thing, I called up Mr. Pete Denny himself and apologized profusely for the crepe myrtle that happened at the beginning of our last video. He accepted my apology, all is right in the world, he has forgiven me of my ways, we're good. And the second most important thing, over 1,000 subscribers in 6 days. That just blows my mind. I seriously can't thank you guys enough for that. That's just, that's awesome. It's got me pumped, it's got me amped to make content and keep this train rolling, and I'm glad you're along for the ride. Now, before I dive into the subject of this video, I just wanted to recap what happened last week, where we were at, what we were doing, all that good stuff. We were down in St. Petersburg, Florida for the Real Green Solutions Show. Now what this is a show primarily for the pros that own their own landscaping businesses or spray businesses in the lawn care industry, all that kind of stuff. And we actually have a lot of clients that go to that, so it was good to meet up with them, keep relationships going, make new contacts, all that good stuff. A couple of highlights from the trip. Number one, we launched this very channel on a Sunday evening, and like I already said, it only took us 6 days to get to 1,000 subscribers, and it was just, it was a whole lot of fun. I gotta thank Matt Martin a lot for promoting the channel and making the plug on his live stream, which we did one night this week, and it was interesting. Note to self, do not try to edit videos during Matt Martin's live stream with all of us in the room.
I agree.
I was hectic. I still don't know why I was trying to edit a video during that event, but it was fun. Day number one and two, I got to sit in and listen to John Perry and Matt Martin teach a couple of classes. Well, not a couple, they both taught, I think, about three or four each for 8 hours each day. And it was really impressive to see them go up there and spout off their knowledge one after another. It was really awesome. It was very informative. Really good stuff. At the end of day number one and two, there was a big social media class that was held by John Perry, Matt Martin, and Alan Hain, the lawn care nut himself, outside by the beach. It was really fun. It was beautiful out there, and it was very well received. They talked about their success and how YouTube helped not only their businesses, but is helping drive the industry as a whole forward and the community that we've built here on YouTube. And the cherry on top, the very last night of the event, they held a big dinner and John Perry busted out his guitar and was joined on stage by Dan Heberlein with Lawn and Landscape Magazine and their friend Dan Shiplove with Permagreen, and they put on a little set for everybody. It was really good. It was really fun and entertaining to watch. And at the end of it all, there was a big debriefing with the Greene County Fertilizer team where we talked about our goals for the year, things that we've learned, all that good stuff. Overall, really awesome show. And speaking of ideas and topics, it was really hard to narrow down where we should begin with this channel. And I think, and John agreed, we both talked it over, that we should start with getting some soil samples in the front and the backyard to see where it's at and where we need to get it to. So that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna discuss how to get soil samples in your yard and send them in for testing. Now at the Real Green Show, I had a chance to sit down with Mr. Mike Hall of Spectrum Analytics and talk about soil testing. That's all they do, and they're really good at it. Actually, John sat down with him and did a video. I'll link that in the description below or that icon at the top of the screen. Hop over there, listen to his little interview that he did with him. Really good stuff, really awesome, nice guy. So I called him up and I clarified some questions that I had personally when it comes to getting soil samples, and here's some of the things that he had to say. Okay, first up, let's talk about the equipment that you're gonna need. First up, you'll need a bucket, something to put the cores that you pull out into. And you'll need a shovel, a trowel, spade, or a soil probe, whatever you can get your hands on. Gonna need something to dig down in and pull those cores out. What I ended up doing is going to my local Home Depot and picking up this little bulb planter right here. The reason I picked up this one, on the side, it's got these little markings, 1, 2, 3, and 4, indicating how deep I'm going. So 1, 2, 3, or 4 inches. Now, when you're getting your samples, you want to at least go 3 to 4 inches. So now you kind of see why I went with this one. I have a clear indication as to how deep I'm actually going. And two, what I really like about this one is once I get down into the soil and get that core and I pull it out, I simply just squeeze the handle and it releases it into the bucket. So thought that was pretty cool. Now, one thing you want to absolutely make sure of is that whatever you choose, a spade, shovel, bulb planter, whatever it is, and the bucket that you're gonna put it into, that it is not contaminated by fertilizer or lime. And the reason for that, just one little granular fertilizer can really throw off the test and screw up the analysis. So again, just make sure that it's not contaminated by fertilizer or lime. You should be good to go. You need about 10 to 12 cores per area. So my front yard, it's Bermuda. My backyard is fescue. So I'm gonna get about 10 to 12 cores from the front and 10 to 12 cores from the back. One thing that I forgot to mention when you're getting your cores, to get a really good sample, go in a zigzag pattern throughout the yard, getting your different cores. So start down there, go in a zigzag pattern, get about 5 or 6 down there, and then 5 or 6 at the top of your property in the different areas that you got.
Look how freaking tough it is to get this in here. It's hard as a rock. Georgia red clay. Gotta love it. Before I go put it in the bucket, here's a little side profile of what I got going on here. Here's one of my cores. It's about 3 inches deep. Of course, here in Georgia, I have the lovely Georgia red clay that I have to deal with. But yeah, there it is.
When you pull out your cores, you wanna make sure that you discard any of the surface residues, thatch or stone or anything that just sits on top of the soil. You wanna get rid of that and put the rest into your bucket. You're gonna collect your cores into a plastic bucket and mix them up really well, then transfer a portion of that, about a cup or more, into a smaller sample bag. So Ziploc bag should do just fine. Now, once you get your sample bags all made up, what you're gonna do is label them with a positive identification that matches that of the soil sample info form. And I'll get into all that when I actually go to fill out the form. But for my cases, I'm gonna call the front simply front 01, and the back with the fescue, I'm gonna call that back 01. So I'll just have the two sample bags. As far as the soil sample information sheet goes, standard name, address, date, phone number, or if you're with a company, same thing, name, address, city, state, zip, contact person, email or fax. Right down here is the section I wanted to go over where it says sample ID. That's what you've labeled on your bag here. So remember how I said I have front 01? I'm gonna put that right here. So front 01 is my sample ID. And the recommendation code, they have a little chart down here at the bottom that identifies the grass type for the areas that you were testing. So for my front, it's a warm season turf, it's Bermuda grass. So I'm gonna do 351 right there. 351. They have different test packages that you can choose from. They have a T1, T2, T3, small, medium, large. Think of it like that. I'm gonna go for the T3 on both the front and the back because that'll give me a really comprehensive, complete soil test package. So we'll do that. Then you can choose to do additional tests here. Sulfur, boron, sodium, soluble salts, nitrate, nitrogen, and soil texture, all that kind of stuff if you would like. And then there's a section here that's just for the lab use. So you need to fill all this out, fold it up, attach it to your soil sample bag, put it into a box or envelope or whatever you got handy, take it to your post office, mail it off, and then wait. One thing that I forgot to mention, I did ask if there is a certain time of the year that is better to soil test than others. And he said that anytime's good, you just need to make sure that you can get down 3 to 4 inches. That is the key. Get down 3 to 4 inches, to get a good core sample. So if you're buried by ice or snow, you could clear that off, dig down 3 to 4 inches, you're all right. That is the key. I can't stress that enough. 3 to 4 inches to get your cores to put into the sample bag and mail off to get it analyzed. So we're doing this for a couple of reasons. Number one, Mike Hall from Spectrum Analytics recommends that you soil test every 3 to 5 years. And number two, we're gonna take a look at the results to figure out what kind of program we need to put together using our Greene County Fertilizer products and get the soil back to where it needs to be. All right, so there you go. That's how you get soil samples in the yard. If you still have questions or need clarification, leave those in the comments section below and I will do my absolute best to answer those for you. I have a goal to answer every single comment on our videos. So I really hope I didn't just pigeonhole myself. So there you go, hit the thumbs up if you like this video, subscribe to the channel, share the video, all that social media fun stuff, you know how it goes. Keep on keeping on, my lawn care brothers and sisters from other misters, and I will catch you next time. So we just got done eating. It wasn't really a lunch. Wasn't really a dinner.
Yeah.
Is it appetizer?
Appetizers, a couple 2-3 beers.
Yeah, Matt Martin's parking and checking in. And so Alan and I, we didn't drive down to where we ate, we walked.
Yes.
So we could soak in all of this. Check this out. Such a beaut. Such a beaut. Ain't it a beaut out?
Listen, this is why we live here on the west coast of Florida.
Such a beaut.